At the onset, I would like to thank Help Library for inviting me over here. And it's very nice to see how Help Library is doing such activities for awareness about general health for the public at large. So before I start my talk, I will give you a short story, because you know my talk is going to be a little humorous, because I don't want any of you to, I will not allow you to take a nap. So that is my guarantee. Okay, that's good. Okay. This is a story about the boss getting kidnapped. So what to do? It's like employees of a company are all worried. You know, some are roaming around, some are in loud discussions during office time. So some trainee who had just joined, you know, he notices this and inquire about what happened. He asked to a senior employee, you know, why so much hustle back is happening. So they ask, what's going on? Why so much people are panicked, and what's all this discussion all about? So he says, the terrorists have kidnapped our boss, and they are asking for rupees 10 crore. It's a multinational company, you know. So that's almost like a $2 million at that time as a ransom. Otherwise, they are going to dose him with petrol and set him on fire. So we are going from desk to desk. After all, he's our boss, you know. So taking up a collection, we need to help somehow or the other. So this trainee who had just joined, he had not even got his first salary also. So he said, how much everyone is contributing? So he was a little worried, you know, how he has to contribute something on an average. So the reply he got, about 1 liter. The message of the story is, this is, we are living in a competitive world, and everybody is there to take away. It's a cutthroat competition. So they are not collecting money, they are collecting petrol. So whatever the boss, we can do it. And that comes the lifestyle related disease, what lifestyle we all are living, especially in a corporate world and in a metro cities, especially like Mumbai. Now, when we say disease, before that we should know what is health. So then only we can understand disease. Now, WHO, World Health Organization, has defined health as not only mere absence of disease, but a physical, mental, social, emotional, and spiritual well-being. So if someone asks you, do you have a disease, do you have blood pressure, do you have a diabetes, and if you say no, so you can't say you are healthy. That is one aspect, physical part. Are you mentally healthy? Are you emotionally healthy? Are you spiritually healthy? So there are a lot of aspects of it. And when you say you are healthy, all these aspects are important, and that should be there. So health is, of course, a fundamental right. It is an integral part of development of not only of a person, but a society, nation, and a healthy world around us. If you are healthy, your society is healthy. If your society is healthy, your city is healthy. Your city is healthy, your state is healthy. Your nation is healthy, and so on. So health is, of course, very important thing. And we know how the mankind has evolved over a period of time. We, our ancestors, and now in last 50 years, how the things have changed, we know. Earlier, you used to say an apple a day keeps a doctor away. Now with 1,000 rupees dozen of apple, people say it's better to go to a doctor rather than buy an apple. But the moral of the story is, why we used to see the things have changed, the evolution has occurred over a period of time. Our ancestors, we know, we are coming from a four-legged animal, and now from there we became two-legged, and things in the era of computer, again we are going back to four-legged animal. So that is how the things are changing on it, and this is where the things are lying over here. And what is today's lifestyle? No, you always say, I am available 24/7, you know. Now, what do you mean? That means the person is not sleeping, not eating. He says he is 24/7 available. I am sure you must have heard this, I am available 24/7. Means no entertainment, no social life, no exercise, no regular eating, no sleeping patterns. Time is converted into money. Money, money, money. It's a money game. Personal priorities take a back seat. Corporate interest and personal ambitions take center stage. I want to become this, I want to become that, I want to compete with this, I want to get this project. So what is the result? It is the affluent society disease. Now, factors like heredity, sex, age cannot be avoided. One must manage one's lifestyle to avoid being at risk of different lifestyle dominated or related diseases. Because if you don't take care, you are going to be the victim of such diseases. Now, what do you say when you say lifestyle diseases? It is already a number one killer in India, as per the D. Prabhakaran from All India Institute of Medical Science, New Delhi. He has already said, and the important factors for these lifestyle diseases are increased consumption of tobacco, dietary consumption of fats, lack of physical activity or physical exercise, and inadequacy of stress coping mechanisms. Everyone has a stress. How do we cope up with the stress is the most important factor. And these are the predominant factors which leads to lifestyle related diseases. In earlier time, we used to see this in reality. You know, there were family, our forefathers, and were doing really farming was one of the most active part in our country. And rather 80% of our population was involved with this type of activities. The things have changed. Now, this is the scenario which we are seeing nowadays. And such a lovely burger we see, and you know, you get tempted to eat this. Now, what is this burger? It is nothing but we call it a coronary burger, which fills your belly, it fills your arteries, and then fills your coffin. And that is the coronary burger which is there. And such delicacies, you know, it is, you feel it's yummy, but is it, how far it's good and what it leads to? In today's time, it is not the adult obesity, but we see more and more of childhood obesity. I'm sure you must have seen in your family, neighborhoods, friend circle, even the children, 10 year, 12 year old, you will see, you can quite plumpish. And you for he is healthy, khate pite ghar ka ladka ladki hai, but it is not khate pite. It is, yes, it was considered at one time, but it is definitely is a sign of inviting problems, which is a fact. India is changing. We know the people are ready to spend. Quality of life comes first. You know, today the Sadhu Maharaj also will fix up the appointment with you. You have to come for Satyanarayan Puja on mobile only. But at the same time, we have seen he may be doing puja in the morning and evening he will have, which is a, I mean, not to discuss saying about anyone, but this is what the lifestyle is all about, because he is also surrounded by such situation. Years back, our deputy home minister had promised that Mumbai will convert into Shanghai. All of you are aware of it. And this is the Mumbai which was there in that time, the largest slum in the world called Dharavi. And he has put that I am going to put this into Shanghai. Now, how it is going to come? It is the change of lifestyle also. And this is what the projected Mumbai in 2020. And there you see in the center, that is the Ashish building, which is in redevelopment, maybe at that time. And madam will be doing with a hi-fi technology all this work. And you will have a huge area for this. The things are going to change because of the lifestyle. We know how the things are changing, the molds which are coming up over a period of time, the big cars, imported cars have come. Not only that, the government has done, oh, we are not just looking for a high class of people. Not affording, don't worry, we have got something for you also. But don't walk. Why? We are providing you now at the cost of two-wheeler, if you can go for a four-wheeler car also. And as a result of which we see this syndrome called male pregnancy. I am sure you must have seen everywhere this male pregnancy coming up. And then you can literally ask, oh, is it 7 months, 6 months, 9 months, 8 months full term? We do see that. In good old times, when you the kids used to play in the grounds and all, the things have changed literally. In fact, I was recently visiting China and I was surprised. Like I met my friend over there and I asked him, where are your kids? He said, they are playing football. I said, fantastic. I was wondering. Then I suddenly realized it is late in the evening. It's so dark. How they are playing football? They said, no, they are in the inside room. They are playing football. So they were playing on a PlayStation. And that is the thing. How the things are changing. This is what we teach, we give in advice. We are happy our children are, you know, playing on a PlayStation because we have modernized. But what is better, whether they're playing on the grounds or this better? And above all, if you see in the vacation, you see the kids, what will do? They will just lie down, watch the TV or in front of a PC, playing just a video game or chit-chatting on the media or social networking sites. And above all such advertisement, you know, it says it takes 12 muscles to smile or 3 simple ingredients, just potato, all natural oil and a salt. So they said you require 12 muscles to smile. Why use those 12 muscles? Just use 3 ingredients and you can be happy. Now this is such a wrong message. It percolates to our younger generation and they will be tempted on that. So all this has led to a condition called obesity and metabolic syndrome. Now, when we say metabolic syndrome, just to get it, it's a multi-dimensional risk condition. There are various conditions or factors into it. It is like you consider hypertension, you consider obesity, you consider diabetes, consider insulin resistance, atherosclerosis, where you get blockage in the arteries, you get coronary heart disease when you get a heart attack, you have a chronic kidney disease, you have a peripheral vascular disease, you have a cerebrovascular disease, that is a stroke, paralytic attack, or you have a liver disease. These all, yeah, hypertension, high blood pressure. So in all, the base is the bomb, that is the metabolic syndrome. So if you have a metabolic syndrome which comes because of obesity, you are a candidate from any of these factors. So imagine, just one simple entity of obesity can lead to so many diseases. It's not that one obese person will have everything. One person can have a stroke, other person can have a BP, third person can have diabetes, fourth can have a paralytic attack, but it can lead to so many conditions. So we know what is the need of life. We know, everyone is aware of it, but at the same time we know fact of life. I am sure in a buffet, if 2 plates are kept, counters are there, there will be a rush at this counter and not at that counter. We know the solution is at our head, but I am sure when we go to wedding, even in desert, there will be fresh cut fruits will be there, and there will be nice pastries, cake, high pudding. Everybody will go over there, whether it is you or me. But it is a tendency, human, looks yummy, delicious, so we go over there. And above all, we have these joints everywhere, which people can identify. You know, let it be a pizza burger, or this is a yogurt, Domino's or McDonald's. We called it modern high fat, high carbohydrate diet. Today also, I was not finding the place over here. When I called up, the landmark they gave, you've seen the Domino's, just come across it. And because they know this is very easily located. And you have, you know, the symbol they have kept so nicely. You know, it's the symbol. Our 5-year-old kid from a distance will identify, Mom, Dad, I want to go to MacD, that is McDonald's. And they have kept a right symbol which suggests, I am for invitation for metabolic syndrome. I said, come and have food with us regularly. You will be a candidate. You will become a person with a metabolic syndrome. And I hope no one is from McDonald over here. And we are Indians, so phir bhi dil hai Hindustani. Why do we say so? Because we Indians are prone for heart attack, diabetes at much younger age compared to our people in the West. People in the West will get it at 50s and 60s, and we get heart attack in 30s and 40s. You must have heard that. You know, 35-year or 40-year young guy getting a heart attack, because our lifestyle is different, our genes are different. So when we talk of coronary artery disease, you know, remember one thing, there is nothing called a sudden heart attack. You must have heard, that this person, still when he slept he was all right, and when he got up he was no more. You must have heard that so often. But there is nothing like a sudden heart attack, because It requires years of preparation. He has prepared himself for years, being a healthy tummy over there, having such junk food, physical inactivity. So he was preparing himself to invite that, and it happened on one fine day. So his preparation was going on for quite some time. It is nothing as sudden heart attack. So you must understand, so what are the risk factors for it? Let's take alphabetically. So it's very simple. When you say A, what are the A? Age. Once the age increases, the risk of heart attack increases. Addictions. Of course, if you are addicted to tobacco or smoking, the risk increases. Again, A for anxiety. The person who are more anxious about everything, small things, you know, very hyper, and again they are prone for heart attack. Coming to B is a blood pressure. If you have a high blood pressure, again you have a risk for heart attack. C, cholesterol. If your cholesterol levels are high, you are more prone for having a heart attack. Again, C comes for cigarettes. If you are a cigarette smoker, you are at risk for heart attack. D for diabetes. All diabetic patients are very, very at high risk for heart attack. And diet, if you don't take care of your diet, again you can be at risk for heart attack. Exercise, that is lack of exercise, if you are not exercising, in fact there has been study which has shown lack of exercise is as risky as a cigarette smoking. So you can imagine, you tell your neighbor, oh, you are smoking, you will die of heart attack. At the same time, if you don't do exercise, you are at the same risk. He is doing smoking, he is smoking, but he is doing regular exercise. And if you are not smoking and not doing exercise, both are at equal risk. So that is one thing alarming we should be aware about. F, fat. Of course, more you are fat or obese, more there is a risk for heart attack. Family history. If your parents, father or mother, has died of heart attack, your risk of having heart attack increases. So here, obviously, you can't change your parents, but at least you should be careful on that. And G, gender. Of course, the male are at increased risk compared to female, especially till female is menopause. So these are the just risk factors, out of which certain are non-modifiable risk factors, where you can't do anything. Like age, risk increases with age, but you can't do anything, so you have to accept that. Gender, of course, as I mentioned, men have a greater risk after 45 years. Women's risk begins after 55 years, and after menopause risk doubles. So of course females are little protected till the menopause. Family history, as I mentioned, if immediate family members had heart attack before the age of 65 years, you have a high risk. You can't change your parents, so you have to take it as a gift from your parents, like they give wasiyat, varsagat, everything, that you have to accept wholeheartedly.
Hereditary,
absolutely. But there are modifiable risk factors, of which certain are controllable and treatable. Control means you can definitely control on cigarettes, smoking, alcohol, weight, which you can definitely control. And treat is, you have to treat if you have a diabetes, hypertension, high cholesterol. If you have, you can't do, you can't just remove it, but then definitely you can treat it so that your chances of getting heart attack reduces. Now let's see about the smoking. Now hope and no one is smoking from this audience over here. Now you have this earlier, the media and the TVs and all were showing, and they see their, you know, role model smoking. The younger generation get tempted. Luckily, now the health ministry has done a very nice thing. In all last 3 years, they have put as a statutory warning, which is mandatory. Whenever they show a shot of any smoking, anyone, hero, heroine smoking, it is mandatory that to put on this thing, that it is cigarette smoking is injurious to health, because otherwise the generation, younger generation, will take it in a wrong sense. So that is one good move the health ministry has done over here. Now when we say about the smoking, because nicotine from the smoking, that is from your cigarettes, accumulates in the blood vessels. It doubles your risk of heart attack, reduces oxygen in the blood, damages blood vessel walls, It contributes to high blood pressure and it contributes to low levels of HDL cholesterol, that is good cholesterol. So it is detrimental in every way. In fact, you know, we should always say no to smoking. The cigarette, as someone has nicely said, it is nothing but a pinch of tobacco rolled in paper with fire at one and a fool at the other end. So it is, you need to take, really you want to burn your life or what? So that is what it is, very important number. Now here, you know, a person who is smoking one cigarette, you know, he reduces his life by 20 minutes. It has been found statistically. If you smoke one cigarette, you have reduced your life by 20 minutes. So you can go and how much you want to reduce it, it's a very nice way of suicide, you can say, indirect way of suicide. Now coming to alcohol, people say, oh, alcohol is good. Yes, no question, it is beneficial to heart, but it is in moderation. It increases good cholesterol, that is HDL cholesterol. Again, of all, wine is fine, but what is important is moderation is required. And who decides the moderation? It is usually the one who drinks decide. No, I drink very little. I just drink 4 to 5 drinks every day. I don't drink much. So now they decide moderation. It is important, it interferes with insulin action. So it is bad for diabetic patients, can cause hypoglycemia. And those who take regularly, say one peg or one drink a day, they said, I will have a beneficial effect on the heart. Yes, definitely. He will not die of heart attack, he will die of liver cancer. So the problem is, it's not one end, he will die from the other issues also. And the problem again with the alcohol is, it is not per se the alcohol, the companions of accompaniments of alcohol. You say, are chicken tikka leke a jao, mook bhaji leke a jao, fried fish leke a jao, you know, those are the all your accompaniments of alcohol which are detrimental. So finally end result is obviously what goes inside the body. So you are end up at the end of the day with everything which is detrimental. There is somebody had said nicely, you know, has argued it, and he said, when we drink, we get drunk. When we get drunk, we fall asleep. When we fall asleep, we commit no sin. When we commit no sin, we go to heaven. So let's all get drunk and go to heaven. This is then said by Brian or Rauke. This is the argument people say comes about of it. Now coming to weight. Now excess body weight, of course, increases your risk of not only high, it increases risk for high blood pressure, high cholesterol, high triglyceride, diabetes and heart disease. And somebody also had said, you know, if you are standing in a queue on a bus stand, it occupies more space on the bus stand also, because with his tummy, he is going to occupy two people's space also. So there are a lot of detrimental effects on it. And we know how the things have progressed over a period of time. And again, this I am stressing upon, we are seeing even in a younger generation, it is a pot belly which is coming up. You see some often 16-year, 18-year boy, you know, he will be there with a paunch also. Now, how do you say obesity? For you, it is important whether do you fall into that category. You need to, there are two ways. One is check the waist circumference. If it is 80 centimeter and above for females and 90 centimeters and above for male, you come in the category of obesity. Or the better is BMI, calculate body mass index, which is calculated by check, put your weight in kilograms. You must be knowing 70 kg, 68 kg, 82 kg. So put weight in kilograms, divide by height in meter square. Now how do you divide? Suppose you are 5, everybody would know I am 5 feet 6 inch. So 5 feet is 150 centimeter. You convert your height into centimeter. So 5 feet is 150, 1 feet is 30 centimeter, 5 feet is 150 centimeter. 6 inch is another 15 centimeter, 1 inch is 2.5 centimeter roughly. So you, when you say you are 5 feet 6 inch, you are 165 centimeter. Now convert it into meter, which is very simple, 1.65. So suppose your weight is 70 kg, so you will put 70 above, divide by height in meter square. So 1.65 into 1.65. That's it. And that will give you the BMI. Normal BMI should be 18.5 up to 23. When you are between 23 to 27, you are considered as overweight. And when you are above 70, you are obese. So I'm sure today all of you will check your BMI, whether you come in which category. Normal, overweight or obese. That is very important. This is the gentleman who is in the Guinness book as of now today. He is Bob Gillett from UK. He's just 25 years. At first look, you will not believe it. His weight is 225 kg. His height 150 centimeters. His waist is 185 centimeters. Look at the things. His waist is more than his height in centimeter. His circumference is more than his height. Look at that numbers. His BMI comes to 86 kilogram per meter square. And his daily intake is 7,000 kilocalories per day. It's amazing. He is alive. But how many more years? How many more years? We don't know. Let's hope he lives long. But it will be, if he continues like this, there will be very soon late will be put before his name. So that is what, just to show you the how things are. Now, there are two types of obesity. So which you should know, which type of obesity is dangerous. One is apple-shaped and second is pear-shaped. When you say in a female, classically you have a pear-shaped obesity, which is more on the hips and buttocks, which is good. And apple-shaped is the central obesity, the paunch. So that is bad. And the male obesity is usually the central type. Now, of course, we do see in females even that type of obesity. But pear-shaped is very good. It is protective, rather more the big, larger the size of the hips, it is the protective one. Now, why there is so much weight gain happening in the society over a period of time? Because of course, the eating habits, we know how the things what we eat, we know we have no control over it. There's the fast food which has come over a period of time. And not only that, the worst part is what is natural in the world, like people would love to eat, what we have done. We have bottled the nature. We have put natural things in the bottle and given artificial. So what we are supposed to eat, consume naturally, we are not doing so. And above all, such advertisement, you know, by again from the media, from our the role models, everybody come taste the thunder, and you name, you know, whether it is Amir Khan or Shah Rukh Khan or Akshay Kumar, and they will come with the big brands, and our young generation get easily trained away. You know, they are making crores of rupees for this advertisement to spoil the nation. We know, but it's so difficult to convince the younger generation. They say, look at them, I am like a Shah Rukh Khan or I am like Akshay Kumar. So I was mentioning about this eating pattern. Now what has happened is, earlier you used to have a Mac, what we have become, the size has increased, now you have a Maharaja Mac. Earlier you used to have a Vada Pav, now whatever, they will advertise us, now we have got calm in the same price, Jumbo Vada Pav. And you had pizza, cheese pizza, now they will say, it's a double layered cheese pizza, same price, and you get tempted. Oh wow, in the same price I am getting this. But that means in the same price, you are killing yourself more and more. So do not upsize, we need to minimize, not to maximize. So what the reason for what I was mentioning is the increased energy density of food. This is the standard food portions have increased over the last 20 years. Earlier people used to have this French fry or potato chips, but you know, it was a serving was small, say it was serving like a 210 calories. And today you will see what the serving will come, it will have a 610 calories. Now look at the other dishes, like burger, which will earlier was a 380 calories, now the today's burger will have a 590 calories. So see, the same thing, the serving has increased, and that is result we are seeing more and more obesity. And all these things has led to, this is the actual data from the Mumbai Police Department. This is the commissioner of police, assistant commissioner of police, deputy commissioner of police at one time. What has happened? Drop in belt level. Higher the position, the belt level has gone down. Look at this. So that is the thing. That is the prosperity what somebody was mentioning, that how the things have changed over there. With the permission of them, we have taken this photograph also. And there are drugs for obesity. And it has been said that anti-obesity drugs accounted for sales of a nearly half billion US dollar in global market during 2000. And that time it was said that it going to be triple by this 2010, which is gone, which is unfortunately the Indian government had banned those drugs. Otherwise, we had to have, because if we start buying those, you know, we should have, by this time the Reserve Bank could have come out with a special currency note. I hope we have only one such, that is more than enough, right? Okay, so this is how has led to obesity. And what is diabesity? It is the companion of obesity. It is nothing but diabetes following obesity. It is going to follow. It is just in comes as a combination. It is one pay, one free. It is your package. Come that. So, this is the data of India, the world considered as the world capital of diabetes. In 1995, we had 19.4 million population, and in 2025, it is estimated, this is the WHO estimation, there will be increased by 140%, and we will have a 57.2 million people who are suffering from diabetes in India only. It's a huge number. You can see, it's a huge number. So by that means, every fourth person will be diabetes in India. So say for example, if eight are sitting over here, two of them will be diabetic.
Now it will be, sir.
I mean, so, but imagine, sir, here we are talking of here senior people. This I am talking of general population, which will be 20 year, 30 year, 40 year, 50 year. And there will be, every fourth person could be a diabetic. It is going to be really worst for our country. So we know India is a rich heritage. You have a different culture, different language, different religion, different ethnicity. But are we really proud to be Indian by calling it the diabetic capital of the world? It is really, we are ashamed for that matter at least. We feel proud to be an Indian, but we are ashamed that we are, as a country, we are the capital of the diabetic population. So you should know your blood sugar levels. What are the normal blood sugar levels? When you check in a fasting state, that is before consuming anything, when you get up in the morning, it should be between 60 to 100 milligram percent. I'm sure all of you must have checked by this time. And a post meal, when you take 2 hours after lunch, that is a resting, it's a post meal. You know, sometimes laboratory people will tell you, are you come in a fasting, jara baju mein jao, thoda breakfast leke a jao, 2 ghante mein aapka sugar check kare. That is not the right way. I'm sure quite a few laboratories will tell you, go to the nearby place, have some breakfast, come after 2 hours. That is not post meal. For checking proper, you should be consuming your routine, natural, normal diet at routine scheduled time, and then check 2 hours after that. That is your called as your perfect post meal.
That should be post meal after 2 hours after lunch.
2 hours after lunch, it should be. So it is not any meal, or it should not be just after a hasty breakfast or anything you have. And that should be between 91 to 140 milligram percent. Sir, yeah.
Instead of 2 hours, it becomes 2 hours and 15 or 20 minutes. Does it change a lot?
Not change a lot. See, the 2 hours will give you the standard. Now, after 2 hours, it will start falling down. So, suppose if it is, say, 160, it will show you 150 at that time. Right? So, it will have not some drastic difference, but you will have... Yes, maybe some difference will come. It will be important for, you know, categorizing someone as a normal blood sugar versus abnormal. If your sugar is, say, post lunch is 310, and if you check it to, instead of 2 hours, 2 hours 15 minutes, it will be 290. Doesn't going to make much difference. But if your sugar is, say, 150, and if you check it after that, it will be 139, and you will feel, oh, I am normal. But in fact, you are not normal. You are just above cutoff. So you need to take care at that time. So there it will make a difference in that.
Sir, so, what about senior people?
no difference, same value. So don't have that image that your number has to go up. So as I said, random sugar, if you check any time of the day, especially if you have taken after the meal immediately, it can go even up to 160, but it has to be below 160 at any given time of the day. It should be less than 160 milligram per dl. Coming to cholesterol, all of you know, I'm sure all of you must have got it done, your lipid profile or cholesterol level, which needs to be checked periodically. And again, in managing the diet, which is the key to health, which you should be knowing it. Okay, blood pressure, again, I'm sure all of you must have checked it periodically. The normal blood pressure should be less than 120 by 80 millimeters of mercury. When you have the systolic, that is the upper one, your BP, you have two readings, the systolic and diastolic, or the upper one and the lower one. The upper one, borderline hypertension, you call it when it is between 120 to 139, and the lower one between 80 to 89. And when do you call someone as a hypertension or high blood pressure? When it is more than 140 by 90 millimeters of mercury, you call it as a hypertension.
If only one is high,
then yes, it is possible.
That what you call 90, it is there at 80-85.
But the first one, yes,
might be 150, 160.
Then it is called as isolated, that is isolated as single systolic hypertension. So you can have, when you say hypertension, you mean both systolic and diastolic. But especially in an elder population, you will have a isolated systolic hypertension where it could be 180 by 80, 170 by 84. So, but still that requires treatment. That is point needs to be kept in mind, requires treatment. So, what do we do now after seeing that all these lifestyle which causes all these problems, it needs to be changed. So, what are the fundamental determinants of lifestyle? You know, we'll talk that, okay, you need to do a lifestyle modification. It is say in Sanskrit, there is a book called as Susrut Sanhita. I'm sure you might have heard of that, in which it is mentioned Ahar, Vyohar, Vichar and Achar. It comprises of your lifestyle modification. When you say ahar, it is nutrition, that all of you are aware about. When you say vyohar, it is your behavior, which is very important. How do you behave to yourself, to your family members, to society? That is vichar, is thinking. What are your thinkings? If you have a positive thoughts or a negative thoughts, that has an impact on your health. Achar is the conduct, the way you conduct the things, your activities. So all this comprises your lifestyle modification. So let's see about the diet. When you so, and you have, I'm sure over a period of time, you have a lot of talks which has been taken at Help Library on diet. So I will not go into details of it, but I wanted to give you some stress on diet, because the importance of diet is mentioned in good old times, Yajurveda. I am sure you have heard of that. It is mentioned that, oh God, give us food which does not cause any disease and also gives us strength. It is mentioned in Yajurveda. Not only that, there is a reference in Mahabharata. It is said that he who takes food in proper measure lives a long life and lives without disease, gets strength and alertness of mind. So imagine the role of diet, the value of food was known your ages back. So for healthy living, to conquer stress, you need to examine your diet, lower your salt intake, which is very important, lower your intake of refined sugars and carbohydrates, and lower your caffeine intake. If you are taking a coffee or tea very frequently, you need to cut it down on it. And it's not that everything what is suggested is to remove. There is something which is very important to add also. And that's a good news. Add to your diet vegetables, fruits, complex carbohydrates, vitamins and water, which is a very important thing. Easily available, free, without anything. If you are adequately hydrated, you will stay away of quite a few diseases. And for a normal person, your water intake should be at least 50 ml per kg body weight per day. That should be your dictum. So if you are 60 kg person, 60 into 50 is 3000 ml. So 3 liters of water intake per day, which you should be consuming. So now you check it. Are you consuming that much water in 24 hours? That is the ideal consumption. And you don't have to spend for it. Luckily, we have enough of it.
Yeah, one thing. Fat is not included.
No.
Salt.
Yes.
Lower intake of refined sugar.
Correct.
Lower caffeine. Lower fat.
Of course. That I already mentioned it. So that is, I have not repeated the things also. Here I wanted to state there are some things which you need to add to your diet also. So a nutritionally adequate diet should be consumed through a wide choice from a variety of foods. You have a variety of foods available with you, but you need to select that what you need to take and what you need not take it, and what you should take in a lesser quantities. Now it is very important that I am not saying that you don't have anything. The foods which are good for health, eat often and more, but that is not everything. Things which are not good for health, eat less once in a while, but do not abstain from them totally. Then you will feel, oh, I did not consume that. So that is what it is very important. You need to take them. And this is a very nice scientific paper which is called as Polymeal. I just wanted to, if you have this, we were just mentioning about it. Wine 150 ml per day, fish 114 grams 4 times a week, dark chocolate 100 grams per day, fruits and vegetable 400 grams per day, garlic 2.7 grams per day, and almonds 60 grams per day reduces cardiovascular events by 75%. Look at this amazing number. By just taking care in your diet, if you can have this, you are reducing future cardiac events to the tune of 75%. That means if 4 person is having such diet, 3 out of 4 will not get cardiac problem. It's a huge, huge potential. Only thing is, how many of our general population can afford this? If you calculate this, this comes to 600, nothing less than 600 to 800 rupees per day, per person. So how many our population can really afford that? But this is a scientific data. So for healthy living, another thing is a rest. Get a minimum of 6 hours of continuous rest, which is very important in today's night shift and all. You know, people come early morning, night 2 o'clock, take a rest for 3 hours, then wake up, do some activity, again take a sleep for 3-4 hours. That is bad. When you are sleeping, you need to have a continuous rest for 6 hours, which is very, very important. Exercise at least 20 minutes 5 times a week, and break a sweat to release endorphins, which is very important. You can't go daily, so there is option is given. You have just do 5 times a week, which is good. Now, people say, which exercise? Walking, the simplest exercise. It reduces stress, it strengthens the heart, it strengthens the muscles, improves the blood circulation. It helps quitting smoking, especially those who want to quit smoking. Go for regular walking, go for a morning walk. They will be able to easily take a breath, fresh air, and they will able to quit smoking easily. Now walking massages the leg, it reduces cholesterol, it modulates cardiac stamina, and ideal should be 30 minutes every day. So you have some concession. Ideal 30 minutes every day. Can't do it 20 minutes 5 times a week, but nothing less than that. So that is what it should be done. Now this is the picture of World Trade Center in Chicago, where, you know, it's very surprising, people are waiting in the queue to go upstairs. Not only that, people want to come downstairs also by escalator. The staircases are vacant. People, if you provide them facility, oh, facility henna, let's use that. Why give trouble to our legs? But then it is not trouble. You are giving benefit to your own body if you have climbed up the things. I had one couple, just giving in practice, they used to come, the husband was very sedentary, obese, not used to go for walking. Wife used to come and crib every time. Doctor, you please tell him he should go, he's not listening. Then once she came alone, she said, now you have to do, he is almost 95 kg, not doing anything. Then something struck me. I said, you have a little puppy at home. And you know, those puppies require to taken for a stroll. By evening, morning, you have to. I asked them, who takes this puppy for a stroll? So she said, obviously, where this fellow going to take him? I take myself for a stroll. I said, your husband loves this puppy or no? She said, yes. Then I said, simple. You just say, I won't go from tomorrow for a stroll with the puppy. So let him go. He will automatically go. He said, yeah, that's a very good idea. She was happy. So I said, chalo, let's work. They came after a month. So I thought things must have gone, everything same. But the husband was the same. He did not look that he has reduced. Wife was little upset. So I asked her, so who is taking the puppy for a stroll? The husband said, of course, I am taking. Wife said, wait, I will show you the photograph. She had a photograph in her mobile. And this is how he takes the puppy for a stroll. Lifestyle, you know, this is what he said. I will go out, yes, but I will take my puppy also for a stroll. And this is how he takes his puppy for a stroll. Okay, so there are certain simple things which can make a big difference, like use the stairs, modifying the design of the buildings to encourage the use of stairs. You know, there has to be the stairs. If you use it, it's fine. The lift should be kept halfway. There are certain buildings I have seen where the lift goes exactly halfway. So either you have to climb half story or come down half story. So even people who are staying on 15th floor, even they'll go, but at least half floor they have to come up or go down. That has been coming up now. There are walk and joggers park, examining urban design to make neighborhoods more walkable. You know, if there are more joggers park, walking tracks, people will go for it. Footpaths and bicycle lanes, which is very important. Today, if you see two-wheelers, if the traffic is jammed, your two-wheelers will go on the footpath. And where the place for the pedestrians to go for a walking. So if such things are promoting active transport by providing a safer and more integrated network of footpaths and bicycle lanes. Abroad, there are separate lanes for bicycles. And that, you know, it encourages people to go for this bicycle. Another is food labels. Now, calorie counters, improving food labeling to help consumer make informed choices. You know, invest each and every item, there is a food label that it contains so many calories, it contains so many carbohydrates, so much fat, so much protein. Things have changed. Now you have a pre-packed things which you buy from a standard company, you will have all this written. But if you go to local Karyana or a local sweet shop or wafers or anything, they will give you 100 gram anything. Correct. But it should be mandatory that each and every food item there should be calorie calculator should be there. Coming to yoga, it's not just a few posture or asanas. It is a better way of life, like diet, physical activity, healthy routines, adequate rest, relaxation, sleep, balanced state of mind, and positive attitudes. There are various asanas, I'm sure there has been. In fact, Monday you have one more session on yoga only, right, madam? So you are going to learn more and more about this. It has a cardiac benefits also. So I will not go into the details of it. Now you will be wondering what these celebrities are doing over here in this talk. Now all these big celebrities are very much into yogas. In fact, one of them, like Shilpa Shetty, has come out with her own video on yogas, and probably Help Pulse Library might be having that also. But why don't they come and encourage younger generation? They can be a role model for a lot of our younger generation. Oh, Angelina Jolie is doing, or Shilpa Shetty is doing, they will come forward for this. But they will not come forward so actively for this. If this thing happens, again, that will have an impact in our society also. Meditation, you know, again, it is a new way of keeping, reducing your stress. So, for healthy living, you need to learn and manage your anger, because anger affects your health. Anger causes you to overreact to many situations. You need to overcome such situations also. Make an increased effort to organize your life. ask for help, delegate the things when you need to. So you need to streamline the things, which will make the things simpler. For healthy living, talk things out with someone you trust, which is very important. Sometimes there are so much things in your heart, you can't want to come out with someone, but then you need to select the right person, and then you need to come out, a family member or a good friend you select out. But that will, you know, whatever is suppressed or kept in your heart, you will feel definitely lighter about it. Now, we get angry often because someone did not do what we thought they should have done it, because we thought so. Are, he should have done that, she should have done that. But that is our thinking. Have we ever thought what they are thinking? And this is all, rethink the situation and learn to be more flexible. That think from the other person's perspective, and that is also a part of your lifestyle modification, to stay away from anger, anxiety, changing the attitude, which will change. Fill your life with fun things to do, keep your sense of humor. We call it a play therapy. Your sense of humor should be there, which will keep you healthy. So your mental health depends on how you deal with your thoughts also. Take charge of your life, act appropriately, don't simply react to stressful situations. Find balance in all that you do. Now, too many people look for an easy answer to stress management by misusing. You know, aaj stress bahut hai, today I'm little tense, let me have two drinks. They just go for drugs, marijuana, take sleeping pills. But these are not solutions. It will give you a one night relief. Next day you are going to back to square zero. So don't just resort to such to be part of your daily routine. Why worry? Worry is nothing but is a misuse of imagination. It is just your imagination. You thought, "Arey, this will happen. If this happens, or if that happens," but that is your imagination. So it is nicely said, if worries can cure your sickness, then go ahead and worry. If worries can prolong your life, then go ahead and worry. If worries can exchange for happiness, then go ahead and worry. And if not, please don't worry. Running water does not flow back, so is life. Make it happy, and it is in your hand. Things you must do every day is smile and laugh. So you should, before you end your day, you should say, have you smiled today or have you laughed today? If not, you have not lived your dead day. So everything in this world can be seen as you wish to, good or bad, simple or complicated, easy or difficult. It's not how things are, it's about how you look up to them, and how you look up to them is all up to you. So what life modification, lifestyle modification for me? Yes, even it for this young kid, lifestyle, life itself says lifestyle improvement for everyone. It starts from a very young age. So let it be a 1 year old kid or 100 year old gentleman, it is for everyone. There are certain difficulties in lifestyle management. You know why? First, his patient is not convinced, or he doesn't say, why lifestyle? You give me one extra tablet, but I don't want to follow. Sometimes doctor is not convinced because he doesn't have time. There is a need for overnight result. Lifestyle modification does not give you overnight result that you stop smoking and next day you are free from all the side effects. Adherence, you need to stick to that. And then there are certain excuses, you know, children's exams are there, so did not go for a walk. There are guests at home. It is raining. Did not go. Why? Because it's monsoon. Then what happens? It's too cold. It's winter. Then what happens? It's too hot. It's summer. And then the excuses go on rising. Sometimes the excuses like there is a wedding in the family, son came from USA, I was out of station, not in the town, maid did not come, for common reason for females. That's a very important aspect. Hey, how can I go for a walk? I need to start doing the work and maid is not going to come. And yesterday, oh, there Shoaib and Sania got married, and there was a, we overnight were sitting and looking at the wedding procession and all that. And the wife will argue sometimes, at least sometimes he can have a good food. we really don't know what is good food. Some good food means otherwise it is all bad food or what? And a discipline which needs to be followed. And then there are certain smart arguments. You know, the SMS which comes, you must have seen, a cardiologist's diet advice is very good. It spit it out, that tastes good. You spit out everything, just taste it, spit out what tastes good. So that means whatever not tasting good has to be healthy, you eat it. Now, some people say keeping away cigarettes, alcohol, good food doesn't give you long life. Life without this only appears long. Then somebody argues that anyway, everybody has to die. Smoke, drink, eat, enjoy and die one day. That is the argument. Somebody also says, why should I waste 2 hours of my life every day today just to have 5 to 10 more years of old age? I am wasting. Now, these are the arguments where you don't have any answer. Somebody nicely argued with me this. A rabbit runs and jumps but lives only for 15 years. A tortoise does not run, does nothing but lives for 300 years. So, exercise is of no use. Be lazy, go crazy. I was crazy after that. And people use this, I don't care what you say, I know better. So, we say, it is nicely said by Swami Vivekananda that we must be the masters and not the slaves of nature. Neither body nor mind must be our master, nor we must forget that thy body is mine and not I bodies. Very nicely said, given the message so aptly for our own body. Not only this, to see the wordings by Albert Einstein, the renowned scientist who had said, the devil has put a penalty on all things we enjoy in life. Either we suffer in health or we suffer in soul or we get fat. So we know, so whatever is good or everything, that is may not be good for our health also. You can't help getting older, but you don't have to get old, which is nicely said by Burns. So, you know, it is how you take our life is. It is your own life. You need to take it and you can make it as a heaven or a hell. And life is summarized in 4 bottles. You start with the first bottle, you end up with the 4th bottle. You decide at what stage you have reached into. I am sure people have reached up to stage 3. So stage 4 is not so far away. And probably, you know, that is the one we need to decide from where we need to take our life. We need to make it heaven or hell. And it is nicely said, what is heaven? Heaven is when you have an American salary, a British home, a Chinese food, a Swiss economy, an Italian body, a Japanese technology, the best technology, African food, and an Indian wife. But sometimes, you know, there is intermingling of this happen and then it becomes a hell. So hell is when you have an American wife, a British body, a Chinese tool which is not going to run long, a Swiss food, pathetic, an Italian technology, no longer good, a Japanese home, does not last long, an African economy and an Indian salary, then your life would be a hell. So what should be the philosophy of life? It is said nicely, Buddham Sharanam Gacchami. It is said in Sanskrit, that means be enlightened like the Buddha. Dharanam Sharanam Gacchami, that is learn from the experienced teachings. And Sangam Sharanam Gacchami, that is learn by bonding with others. So friends, to conclude, summary and conclusion of today's talk would be that urbanization and modernization or modern lifestyle has led to obesity and metabolic syndrome. Prevention is better than cure holds really true for a healthy living. And lifestyle modification is the major key factor in combating lifestyle related diseases. Otherwise, you can be the victim of diabetes, hypertension, high cholesterol, heart disease, stroke, paralytic attack, so on and so forth. Thank you so much for your patient hearing. I think we concluded just at 1 hour.
Thank you.
Yes, and if you have any questions, I will be happy to answer them.